I'm Alicia, and today I'm going to show you 7 powerful ways to use Google Analytics. If you have a website, chances are you're using Google Analytics to track how many people visit it and how they behave on it. Google Analytics is a powerful tool, yet most people don't use it to its full potential. In this video, you'll learn how to use Google Analytics to improve your website. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. So, let's begin. Follow these simple steps to get Google Analytics set up and ready to track on your website. The first step is to make sure you're signed into your Google account that you want to manage your analytics with. Then, go to the Google Analytics setup page and hit Start Measuring. Now, you need to add an account name and leave the data sharing boxes ticked. You can untick them if you want to, they won't change anything with your data. Once you've added that, hit Next. Now, you need to choose the type of property you want to measure: websites, apps, or both. Most people are going to be setting up Google Analytics to track a website, so select that and click on Next. Now you'll be able to add some details about your site. Website name, self-explanatory. Website URL. Make sure to choose HTTP or HTTPS from the drop-down menu, then add your URL. Industry category. Choose the area that best describes your site. Reporting time zone. Pick the time zone that you're in. Once you've completed this section, click Create, and you will be prompted with some terms of service to agree to. Tick both these and press Agree. Now you'll see your unique tracking code. To track your website using Google Analytics, this code must be installed on every page of your site before the closing head tag. Installing the code will depend on the type of site you have and how comfortable you are making the changes yourself. Let's run through 2 different ways. Some WordPress themes have a dedicated section to drop your tracking code into, but most of them don't. That's why you should always be using a child theme to prevent your GA script from being overwritten after every update. Your Google Analytics script should be added to your header.php file before the closing tag head to install it across every page of your site. If your theme doesn't have this feature, you could try using a plugin to create them. One of the easiest ways to add Google Analytics to WordPress for both beginners and experts is to use a plugin like header and footer scripts. This is probably the easiest and safest method for adding a Google Analytics code to your WordPress site. Just install the plugin and add your tracking code to get started tracking. Once you've added the code to your site, you need to test that Google Analytics is actually tracking. This is pretty easy. In Google Analytics, go to Real Time and then Overview. This will show you what's happening on your site right now. Now, go open your site in a different browser or incognito mode and wait for Google Analytics to pick up your visit. If your tracking code has been installed correctly, you'll see something like this. Before moving on, make sure to link Google Analytics with Google Search Console to have a better, more integrated picture of your data. So, now you're all set up. There's a key question you may be asking. What can you do with Google Analytics to improve your website and business? I'm glad you asked. Want to see your most important analytics data without having to dig through the rest of Google Analytics? Then you should make use of Google Analytics custom dashboards and reports. In the left-hand panel, just click on Customization and you'll see them. You can pick just the data you want to see and organize it in a way that works for you. This means you can make your own report simply by adding widgets and moving them around. Here's an example of a custom dashboard that is focused on SEO. Want to know the best thing about custom dashboards, though? You can use pre-built templates, which we've linked in the video description below. We've also linked to a video that helps you set up your Google Analytics account. If there's one or more piece of data you want to see at a glance every time you log into your Google Analytics account, be sure to set it up in the dashboards area. A custom segment is a defined grouping of your analytics data. Segments allow you to track different types of users so you can understand how your site can better serve them. You can use them to drill down into the data you've collected. For example, You may want to segment all your site's visitors based on a particular country or city if you want to focus on local traffic. Another segment could be users who visit a specific page on your site. Or maybe you want to compare mobile versus desktop visitors. By creating a mobile segment and a desktop segment, you can compare the data side by side. There are pre-made segments waiting for you inside Google Analytics. Just open Google Analytics and click Add Segment, and you'll be able to browse and apply the existing ones that have been pre-built by Google for you. To add a custom segment, click the red New Segment button. From here, you can choose how you want to segment your users. As you begin to apply filters, you'll see the summary to the right start changing. This shows you the percent of users you have segmented as well as the user and session data. For example, here's what it would look like if I selected males between ages 25 and 34. Maybe you want to drill down even further and segment by 25 to 34 males who visited your site via SEO or from Google. Go to Traffic Sources and select Google and Traffic Source. Once you're happy with your segment, give it a name and save it. Now, when you apply a segment, you'll be able to apply this custom one you just created. A goal is a completed activity or conversion that contributes to the success of your website. It can be based on destination, event, duration, or pages or screens per session. Setting up goals allows you to better understand the ROI, return on investment, of your site. By tracking goals, you can understand what is working on your site and what needs improvement. To set up goals, go to the admin section of Google Analytics and then navigate to goals. Now, you'll be able to add a new goal. Select the most appropriate description of your goal from the next section. There are a few choices here. If you're not sure, you can just select custom. Next, you'll need to give your goal a name. Give it something descriptive so that you know at a glance what you're tracking. The steps for setting up goals depend on what you want to track. I have a video in the description below that will help you walk through and decide on what method is going to work best for you. You've built enough traffic so that people visit your site, but do you know what's even better? Converting them into customers. Using Google Analytics, you can find out which pages bring in the most traffic and conversions, and then work on improving them to bring in even more. Here's how to find your top converting pages. Go to Acquisition, then Search Console, then Landing Pages, and select a time frame. Aim for at least 6 months. Now you want to sort the table by a conversion goal. Assuming you've got goals set up, pick a conversion from the drop-down top right that you want to investigate. For example, let's say we're interested in the people that complete a contact form on our site. Select that goal and then sort by that goal. This will show us the top converting pages for that goal. So now what? Well, now you need to try and improve that page's conversion rate. Here are a few things that you can try. Look at the keywords that page ranks for and then compare against other ranking pages. Check out how many backlinks the top-ranking URLs have using Ahrefs' free backlink checker. Check what queries drove little traffic to your pages in Google Search Console and update those pages with these new terms. Look at the results in Google and compare your site against your competitors. And use your WordPress SEO guide to make sure you aren't missing anything important. If you are using SEO to get people to your site, you're playing the long game. You need to follow best practices. It's easier if you're using an SEO plugin. Make sure your site is error-free and create evergreen content to see your site gradually climb up the search engine rankings. However, there are some things you can do for faster results. In this case, your low-hanging fruit targets are pages on your website that will see an uplift in traffic with just a few tweaks. These will be pages that are appearing on page 2 of Google and just need a bit more work to bring them to page 1. But how do you find these pages? You need to connect Google Analytics to Google Search Console first. Then go to Acquisition, Search Console, and Queries to see which search terms or keywords are sending the most traffic to your site. Then click on Advanced. Using the advanced filter, select average position as your metric and add greater than 10 and hit apply. What will this show you? This will show you pages that are ranking on page 2, aka your low-hanging fruit keywords. But what you really want to look at here is the relationship between clicks and impressions. If you need a refresher, impressions equal the number of times your URL appears in search results. Clicks are the number of times someone clicks your URL in search results. Now, your clicks are going to be low as these are pages ranking on page 2 of Google. And let's be real, no one goes to page 2 on Google. But if you've got high impressions, this means you could be getting more traffic if you just improved your position. It's not always about finding the good stuff on your site. Sometimes you need to identify your worst performing pages and improve them. Using Google Analytics, you can find pages that have declined and then republish them to regain their former glory. Here's how. Go to Acquisition, Search Console, Landing Pages, and select a time frame. Aim for at least 6 months, and then compare that to the previous year. If you have a pretty new site, don't worry if you can't compare it to the previous year. You can select a date range that you do have data for. Now, sort by clicks. Scan through this and look for pages that have dropped significantly. Then, look for reasons why they've declined and think of any updates you can make or ways you can increase traffic to them. This approach works also for optimizing the conversion rate. In Google Analytics, go to Behavior, Site Content, All Pages, and click on Advanced. Now we want to add a source/medium dimension and add containing Google/organic. This will show your top performing pages from Google only. Now sort your data by the most views and pay attention to the bounce rate and percentage exit columns. You typically see pretty high bounce rates from search traffic to blog posts, so don't worry too much about it. What you want to look for are pages with both a high bounce rate and a high percentage exits. Pages like this. If you're seeing something like this, your page needs improving. There are lots of possible things you could do here to improve this number. That's up to you to test. But there's a few things that could be holding your pages back. Your content doesn't meet the search intent of users searching on Google. Your content is outdated and could do with a refresh. Your content doesn't look good, or maybe it isn't mobile friendly. Your website is loading slowly, so do some speed optimization. Or your content isn't in-depth enough. Google Analytics is a powerful tool that gives you access to a lot of actionable data that you can apply to grow your website. And when paired with other analytics, it's really a must-have for growth. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.